Huawei. Actually, just now I swear around maybe around GSM Arena or Phone Arena, I saw this commercial about the on a side note. Yeah, get it? Note, which is refers to the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. Let's see what it says. On a side note, 120 gigs storage space. 960 frames per second slow motion and 4000mAh battery is already here. My reaction was like, big F deal. Yes, big deal. Yes, even though it translates, transition is quite fast, at least I managed to screenshot. So there is, on a side note, 120 gigs storage space, is already here. But here's the thing. Do you have 256 gigs or even 512? Whereas the Note 9 has the larger internal storage, 512. And if 512 gigs wasn't enough, you still can expand the micro SD card slot, which your phone can't do that. Yes, which your phone can't do that at all. Trust me. Yes, even though your camera's nice, but you compromise so many things here and there. Like, no SD card slot, no headphone jack. And, even though there's a stereo speakers, even though the S9 also has one. Stereo speaker is there, but, actually I'm using my Bluetooth earpiece and the Dolby Atmos enhancement. Wasn't optimized, how should I put it? I still can hear the Dolby Atmos surround using Bluetooth on my S9 Plus, while the P20 Pro, if you want to activate the Dolby Atmos sound enhancement, you have to rely on the USB-C port, through the headphone jack. You can't do that on the Bluetooth, which is there. That means TLDR, you can using Bluetooth to enhance Dolby Atmos on the Samsung device, but the P20 Pro from Huawei can't do that. Okay, there's another thing. 960 frames per second slow motion. Actually Samsung wasn't the first one doing that. It's actually Sony if they are at Z Premium. But that one doesn't have the, how should I put it? It captures, but it doesn't have a trigger to activate whether it's move on to the slow motion. That means you have to, rely on luck and whether it will get a good shot for slow motion or not. Whereas the S9 and S9 Plus or even the Note 9, the slow motion can be activated from your movements, whereas the Sony one doesn't have. Even though the XZ2, I think they are 960 frames per second, has changed the upscale their resolution to 1080p, whereas the Samsung still uses 720p, and as for you, Huawei is still using 720p for the 960 slow motion video. Well done. And the has of the 4000mAh battery, I would say yes, even though Huawei has already done that since their mid series, that doesn't mean anything. I mean, the LG phone, even though they have 3000mAh for since the G2 days now, which is I think it's almost half a year now. It's still more or less somewhat well optimized. But 4000mAh doesn't mean anything. Yes, even though the Note 9 they finally have a large battery. That's why it's kinda tasteless. Or I had to very hard to describe how to say. Like, now you finally have a huge battery. Why you should have put that huge battery in the first place, huh? that kind of pun. Because, you know, your phones, even though it looks beautiful, but it still uses the Kirin 970. Hopefully the 980 will be on the maybe the Mate 20 Pro, which they already development now, if I'm not wrong, even though the Kirin 980 they haven't officially announced yet. So I think it's not really a good idea to kind of pun on Samsung, even though you know Huawei now is already the second largest phone manufacturer. I guess I think it surpassed Apple, and it's going to more or less surpass Samsung sooner or later. But you still have a notch, unfortunately, and I think the Mate 20 will have that notch as well. So, what do you think about this kind of weird adverts? You know, Huawei playing around the Note 9 from Samsung. Let me drop comments below, and I'll see you on the next video. And look forward for my unboxing for the Galaxy Note 9 from Samsung. How should I put it? Okay. Because a few days ago I recently pre-ordered my Note 9, and of course it will be available first on 22nd of August for those who have pre-ordered the Note 9. If you're not sure, you can see my previous video about the Singapore local pricing on the Galaxy Note 9. And that's about it. I'll see you on the next video.